Hi, this is Kevin Deal from Upscale Audio, and today we're going to talk about the JBL 4312G. Oh my god, I love old shit. This is my coffee mug. If you watched the L100 video, you already know the story. When the L112 came out, I guess is when it happened, I was working for a JBL dealer. I was a young pup, probably 22 years old, working at a stereo store. Got to go to the factory, got to go to an anechoic chamber, and this was our fabulous departing gift, this mug. It's the only thing from my misspent youth that still survives today, because everything else, God knows what happened to it. You know what I'm talking about with that? This is a pair of old JBL 4401 control monitors. This was called an L50 back in the day for home use, and then this is the control version of it for commercial use. Isn't that cute? It's like a little baby JBL. And I use these in my office just because I dig old things like this. It's got a great connection. You know, in the last video that we did, I played two beats of a song. Two beats. I'll play them for you again. And the song, as you will hear, is Iron Man. And I really thought that the person that had won that contest would be an old guy. I just thought, oh, it'll just be another old burnout, just like I'm an old burnout, right? No, it was not. The guy that won the contest off of just two beats, thump, thump, it was a young guy. And I was really impressed by that. And I think that there is hope for our future. You know, because when you buy a speaker like this, what's it really about, right? What's it really about? Is it about buying stuff? I don't think so. I think it's about a connection and feeling good. And that's the way it is for me. I think about the speaker and I think about me, and I'm gonna tell you a secret. I will admit that I picture myself as being a rock and roll singer on the stage all the time. And I think about, there was a girl that broke my heart in high school, and I won't say who she is, because she ended up dating a guy who had a van. And in 1975, if you had a custom van, there was just no way I can compete with that, and I lost. And I always thought she'll be in the audience and she'll go, oh my God, I didn't know that Kevin was gonna be a rock and roll star. And I think that everybody out there wants to be a rock star, don't you? I mean, why don't you tell me the truth? It's embarrassing. I mean, I'll tell you what I wanna do, and this time, I want you to, in the comments section, to tell me whether or not you feel that way, because I'm just curious if I'm the only one who's an idiot in this way. And if you want to be a rock star, who it is. And if you don't think that way, you can put a comment too, because I want to find out if there's something wrong with my thinking. So, 4312. In 1969, thereabouts, during the period of Woodstock, that's when JBL came out with these control monitors, the 4300 series. And there was the 4311, which was such an iconic product, and then it became the L100, and then in 1982, they revamped this speaker, and now this is the newest iteration of it. And I gotta say something to you, it is just so unbelievably fun, and I'm like, oh my God, look at it. It looks like an L100, but it's way less. I mean, go to my website, click on the link, and look at what the price on it is. It's like, does that mean I get to a $4,000 speaker for like a lot less? And I'd say, no, you don't. But the thing is, I gotta say something to you guys and gals. I love the L100s. I mean, they're just unbelievable, but these speakers really impress me. And I go, well, what the hell is the difference? There are differences. The L100 has, I think, a denser cabinet, and it's got more internal bracing because I took it apart. The L100 is over 59 pounds, almost 60 pounds. This one's about 52 pounds. So there's about 7 pounds of difference in the weight, but good God, you know, maybe I'll show you a picture of the big mess. Maybe I won't. The sound room was just a big mess, rolling tubes and compared speakers, but I was having so much fun. I compared these level match side by side with the L100s. And I'm gonna say this, I guess the L100s are kind of just a little bit cleaner, and maybe that comes from a cabinet that's a little denser, and maybe the drivers are a little bit better, but these had this just really cool, like, dirty grunge that, and it's not that they're dirty, it's just that they had this thing that made me feel like I was frickin' listening to Ted Nugent Stranglehold, and I was 16, and I don't know. I mean, I just had such a good time, and so did all the employees at the store. We had a great time comparing them. I'm going to say something to you. If you end up buying them somewhere, make sure, I noticed, I go, this panel looks horrible. I go, what's wrong with this panel? I realized, and I even looked at pictures of reviews from magazines. I go, what's wrong with the speaker? There's a plastic film over the top, or over the top of that control. All right, 12-inch woofer, that's pure pulp. I'm gonna show you something. I'm gonna get these out of the way. I'm not gonna do this gracefully. I'm gonna do it right now. I was gonna use the magic of a camera, but, this is the woofer. 12-inch pulp, pure pulp woofer. And I noticed that it is not the same weight, and the magnet structure is different. But it is a pure pulp driver. It has this fabulous butyl rubber edge surround, because some JBLs, like my 4401s down here, the surround on them failed. And that's just a known problem because of California smog and sunlight and all that. It degrades foam surrounding, but they decided to not do that this time. Smart thinking, butyl rubber edge surround. And damn, it is a badass woofer. I'll show you a picture of the inside of the cabinets now, and I'll show you the crossover. And what you're going to see is it does not have the additional internal bracing right behind the woofer that the L100 Classic has. So these are the little step-down things that make these two speakers different. Now, the drivers are the same size. It's a 5-inch pure pulp driver here. I don't know how different it is from the other one, to be honest with you. And then it's a aluminum and magnesium 1-inch dome tweeter with a waveguide built into it. And I gotta say, it's a nice sounding tweeter. Now, they come in a mirror image set. Most of the time, people put the tweeters on the inside of the pair when you're positioning them. However, I do not want you to be afraid of reversing that and putting the tweeter on the outside edge. It's going to depend on whether or not you have your speakers too close together in the first place. You may benefit from that. You have an adjustment for the mid-range and for the tweeter, and Jesus, there's a lot of adjustment to them. Looking at the cabinet here, it's not a real veneer like the L100 is, but it's not the L100 price either. I mean, it's got five-way binding posts. I mean, it's pretty damn respectable. I love this speaker. Now, of course, they come with grills, and they're really cool grills. You can't help but feel good with this speaker. Now, I would suggest you can orientate these either this way or stand them straight up and down like we're doing now. So they're very, very flexible in that way. But for me, the JBL optional stands that are made for this speaker, I think they just kind of complete the look. You know what I'm saying? I mean, of my house when I was a young guy, and when I had a beer keg with a piece of glass that I made into a table, because I think everybody when they were 20 years old had one of those tables. I don't know. I mean, you can't help but smile when you look at these and listen to them. Now, what about the performance of it? The bottom end is really ballsy. You know, it's like a good Ampeg bass guitar amp, ballsy. You know what I'm saying? It's just got this nice growl to it. Now, to get them to image, I had to futz around with them just a little bit, but I think that's kind of typical for a big box speaker like this. It's not a little mini monitor. But I did get good imaging, and I was able to get them to disappear. But it does take a little bit of understanding of speaker positioning, so this is what we're going to do. When you buy a pair of these speakers from us, make sure you check the box to get the speaker setup disc. We'll send it to you in a CD or on a thumb drive, and we're going to send you two different copies, because we decided to have the basic copy for people that are just looking for basic, because you have to do it by ear. If you think you're going to do it with a tape measure, you're out of your mind. It does not work that way. Laser beams, tape measures, measurement, it does not work. You have to do it by ear. You got to get a buddy to help you, and you have to do it while you're listening. But we have a five-step process for doing that, but we also decided to do what we call the OCD version for the obsessive compulsive, and it's for the people that are looking for the ultimate in performance, and we always want you to get that, because you can spend all the money you want a high-end system. If you don't take care of the little details like speaker placement, just don't waste your money. Go get one of those Bosey wave radios. You know what I'm saying? Forget that stuff. So look at the speaker, look at the price, look at the good time you have, and look at the fact that you can just reach back and go, oh my God, I remember I had this long flowing hair, and I remember those platform shoes. Oh my God, when I was drunk, I could barely walk in them. I mean, what a time it was, and we can have those times again. This is the greatest time in high-end audio. This is a time where we get to go back and reach into those things that made us feel so good. Go to our website, we got no interest financing, we take trade-ins, none of my salespeople work on commission. I promise you that at Upscale Audio, we're gonna treat your system like it's ours. Thanks.